Alors, bonjour, mesdames et messieurs. Mon nom est François-Philippe Champagne. Je suis le co-animateur de Libéral en direct avec Bernadette Clément qui est avec moi. Nous venons d'entendre un discours très inspirant de la part de notre leader, Justin Trudeau. Vous pouvez entendre dans la salle et voir les gens. Il y a une énergie incroyable. On a la chance d'avoir avec nous maintenant Rob Silver, who's going to give us his first reaction. Rob, you are an acclaimed journalist in Canada. Give us your key takeaway from this great, great speech from our leader.
There are a lot of pundits and journalists who were saying this is the most important speech since Justin became leader of the party. I always thought that was a bit unfair and setting the bar a little bit too high. But if that is the test for this speech, then he certainly jumped way over that, both in terms of style, delivery, the energy in this room, as well as the substance he started laying out for the next campaign. There is no other political leader in Canada right now who can deliver that speech. So that was a fantastic job by Mr. Trudeau.
Let's talk about the substance a bit. So he was hitting on the middle class, of course, and some of the anxieties that people are feeling. He talked about the Champlain Bridge, the infrastructure. Can you comment on that?
Yeah, I mean, look, there are a lot of people who think that what Justin needs to do is lay out a 42-point plan. And as soon as he puts out a giant platform, then everybody's going to read through that and policy will be here. What he did instead was humanize it, and that's what's so powerful about his leadership style, is you talk about this mom and dad and the family with the kids, and that brings it real to the middle class and to people who are thinking about change and about the next election. So it's a very powerful way of demonstrating why, when we talk about the middle class as a party, it matters, and why the anxieties that this fictitious family is facing are the real anxieties that so many families across the country are experiencing.
Well, there was a lot of theme in this discussion. You know, we talked about education, we talked about First Nation, we talked about the economy, we talked about fairness. It's like the sunny ways from the video, you know. This is kind of, tell us, in your view, what do you think, you know, the energy that has been in this room now that needs to bring that back to the people now in the community?
Well, I think a lot of it is on the ground. A lot of it is selecting candidates and organizing for candidates. But substantively, he set down some very clear markers. One of the memorable parts to me was when he went head on the Senate issue.
Give me a second, Rob. Pablo Rodriguez just joined us.
Hello,
Pablo, welcome. Welcome.
Welcome.
Sorry. Pablo Rodriguez obviously doesn't need an introduction. Everyone in the party knows who he is. So, Rob, let's go back to that. I apologize, Pablo.
Yeah, I mean, there were a lot of important themes and markers that he set down, but one of them was on the Constitution, on the Senate, and especially with an election coming up in Quebec, he went head on, Mr. Mulcair and Mr. Harper, about how irresponsible their approach to the issue is, contrasted with the very practical and very real approach that he's taken. So I thought that was also an important theme in that speech, and I imagine we'll be hearing a lot more of that from Mr. Trudeau and from the entire team in the weeks and months to come.
Alors, Pablo Rodriguez, bienvenue.
Merci.
Je peux vous poser une question en français?
Absolument.
Oui, alors vos réactions face à ce discours vraiment passionné?
Tant sur le fond que sur la forme, c'est excellent. Évidemment, sur la forme, Justin nous a livré un grand discours, plein de confiance. On le voit dans ses yeux qui est tourné vers l'avenir, dans son geste physique. Sur le fond, mais c'est un discours qui est excessivement positif, qui parle des contrastes entre lui et ses adversaires, mais de façon positive, pas en les attaquant ou en essayant de baisser quelqu'un, mais en démontrant qu'il a une vision pour le Canada. Et ça, c'est une nouvelle façon de faire et je trouve ça rafraîchissant.
Oui. Alors, on parlait avec M. Silver qu'on parlait vraiment beaucoup de la classe moyenne et
Mais c'est le cœur et les poumons du Canada,
la classe moyenne. La fameuse Nathalie, hein?
Oui.
C'est la classe moyenne, c'est le cœur et les poumons. Alors, il faut qu'on puisse faire une différence pour ces gens-là parce que c'est toute la société qui en bénéficie.
Dites-nous une chose. Les priorités pour M. Trudeau maintenant. On a eu un grand discours, la salle est énergisée. Tout le monde part d'ici avec beaucoup d'espoir, en sachant qu'il y a du travail à faire. Pour vous, quelles sont les priorités maintenant de ramener, parce qu'on a des milliers d'auditeurs à travers le Canada qui nous regardent de tous les coins du pays, ramener ce message-là chez eux dans leur communauté. C'est quoi les priorités maintenant?
Bien, les priorités, c'est de démontrer qu'il y a une alternative, premièrement, au gouvernement, au régime, je l'appellerais Harper, et qu'on a un gouvernement libéral responsable, mènerait à terme une saine gestion des finances publiques pour pouvoir, de façon claire, établir des priorités qui vont bénéficier la classe moyenne, que l'on soit présent pour nos aînés, que l'on bâtisse un avenir plus vert pour nos enfants et nos petits-enfants, que l'on soit là pour les familles, les jeunes familles, et qu'on change le Canada, qu'on lui donne ce visage moderne et qu'on soit respecté, encore une fois, sur la scène mondiale, comme on l'était auparavant.
Comme on l'a toujours été.
Comme on l'était auparavant, oui.
Now, in terms of the tone of the speech, you talked about the tone, Rob, and he spoke Thursday night and again today about negativity and how that doesn't seem to resonate with Canadian people. What are your thoughts on that?
It's a different way of doing politics, as Pablo mentioned. It's very, very much a reflection on Justin's personality. I mean, the word authenticity gets thrown around a lot in politics. He's authentically positive. I think that's a big part of why Canadians across the country have reacted to him the way he has. But I think what he also showed in that speech is you can be relentlessly positive, but also be tough. There's no chance that in the election campaign that we're going to allow attacks on our leader to go unanswered, that he's not going to call out Mr. Harper and Mr. Mulcair for the deficiencies in their plans and in Mr. Harper's record, but he's going to do it not in a personal way, not in the type of attack ads we've seen from other parties and that we see on air today from Mr. Harper. He's going to do it in a positive, factual way, and you saw a lot of that in that speech.
He warned us, though, that he would be attacked and that the focus would be on him, but that his focus would be on Canadians.
Yeah.
Is that...
I think that's so important. And he also talked about the role of all of the people here and all the people at home, liberals and not liberals, to get out his positive message, to get involved in nominations in terms of running as candidates, helping out candidates and getting involved, and how important that is in terms of building the team and building the organization across the country.
Well, I mean, one thing he said, which I like particularly, is get the big things right.
Yeah.
What are the big things for you, Rob Silver?
Well, the biggest thing is the struggle of the middle class, the fact that our economy has grown, but that middle-class Canadians haven't gotten a raise, and that needs to change because it puts everything else at risk. And that's what the video we put out before the convention talked about and that he hammered on again today, that in terms of our commitment to free trade, our commitment to a growth agenda, unless the middle class feel that they're benefiting, they're getting an increase in their salary, their lives are getting better, then they're going to get angry and they're going to start attacking people. And that's where the danger is, and that's why this is so important.
And the message is going through, by the way, especially here in Quebec. Look back at the last elections. Look at today. There's about 200 people that are interested in running. I already met on a personal basis 90. I spent the weekend talking to people that want to run, but not only here. In Manicouagan, there's 4 people that want to run.
It's absolutely amazing. In your own
region, everywhere.
Yeah, I know.
Not only Montreal, and the new generation of Quebecers and Canadians that want to be involved. That's one of the things that Justin brings to the party.
Et Pablo Rodriguez, il a parlé aussi de l'infrastructure. C'est un thème
de la conférence.
Et le pont Champlain. Donc, puis il a parlé du rôle du gouvernement. Alors, qu'est-ce qu'il voulait dire par ça?
Bien, le gouvernement a un rôle, premièrement, de travailler en collaboration avec les provinces, avec les municipalités. C'est pas à nous de dire, voici quelles sont vos priorités. Par contre, vous avez besoin d'aide, vous avez besoin de partenaires, pas juste à court terme, mais à long terme. We're there. On est là avec vous autres. C'est ça notre rôle.
Dites-nous un peu, Pablo, spécialement du Québec, parce que vous avez été très impliqué au niveau du Québec, les priorités pour le Québec. Quand on prend ce discours-là, puis on se dit maintenant, on parlait d'infrastructure, on a parlé de commerce, évidemment, on a parlé d'éducation, de Première Nation. Les priorités, si on regarde ça du point de vue du Québec?
Bien évidemment, toute la question de l'économie, pour nous, est au cœur de tout. Si on veut avoir les moyens de nos ambitions, si on va avoir les moyens de mettre en place les programmes qu'on veut mettre, il faut qu'on ait une économie saine, une gestion saine. Vous savez, quand on a quitté le pouvoir, on avait 13,2 milliards
Pablo,
de surplus que les consommateurs ont brûlé.
Je m'excuse de vous interrompre, on voudrait vous avoir toute la journée.
J'adorerais ça.
On renvoie au stage principal,
Thank you,
mesdames et messieurs, on
Very
vous voit
much
sur
your
le plateau
commentary.
Principal. Merci.